only just getting started.
Ladies?
Sorry, my English is...
Oh, so you're not from around here?
France.
And French.
René Mbappé.
I'm Dr. Seth Crusoe, and this is my cousin and colleague, Dr. Vincent Crusoe.
Yo, mate, he's an angel. I kind of feel guilty lying to her, though. I'm getting way too good at it.
French girls, bro, French girls.
It's been a lovely evening.
Maybe I can walk you home?
No, but you could walk me back to your place.
Whoa. You guys know each other?
Of course we do. This is my little sister.
Yeah, Tanya Dupreez. It's great to meet you.
Wait a minute. You're not French. Not even a little bit.
You're not still doing the whole French girl thing, are you?
There is something about the French girls. They always get the same old. Especially with the enzyme doctors.
That was a misunderstanding.
Oh my God. You were the girl he brought home last night.
Slapper was the word you used, wasn't it?
Hellcat was the word you used. Gagging for it was also bandied around. Anyway, blah blah. How's school?
Whoa, school.
Nursing school. I've just graduated.
Tanya!
G'day, Mum.
Oh, I'm out of here.
When did you get in? Oh, such a surprise. We weren't expecting you for ages.
I couldn't stay away with it, so as soon as I graduated, I signed on with the agency. Here I am.
Oh, you're temping here?
Yeah, cool, huh?
How does that work when they're firing nurses all over the place and hiring temps?
It's not Tanya's fault. No need to rain on her parade, Maya. Well, come on then.
Let's hear all about it. What have you been up to?
Okay, you can yell at me now.
Scarlett's rolling all this?
Nothing. She didn't even know.
That's something, I suppose.
I'm really, really sorry, Dad. I'm sorrier than I've ever been about anything before.
It's not going to help the girl in hospital, is it?
No.
What was I thinking? I should never have left you kids alone. I thought you were up to the responsibility. Obviously not.
Dad, it's not... I'd never hurt anyone. You know that.
But you did, Jake. And it was an accident, yes, but then you just drove off. That's what I don't understand. I suppose I need to talk to the police. Well, come on, then. Let's get it over with.
I'd rather not drag you off the floor, Doctor, but if Muhammad won't come to the mountain, then...
No, just keep an eye on him for me. I won't be long.
Okay.
What is so important? You've already had my answer about the job as central.
Yeah, and if the answer is still no, then I'll need a resignation.
Well, I'm not resigning.
Excellent. Then you'll be taking the position as central.
No.
Try again. This is an either-or situation.
Well, you may think so, but as far as I'm concerned, I only answer to Andrew, and he hasn't asked for my resignation.
It's a DHB decision. Andrew doesn't come into it.
Well, he's my boss.
Like it or not, I'm making the staffing decisions here. So I'll assume you're resigning.
Well, you can assume all you like. As long as there are patients coming through those doors, I will be in here treating them. The only way you will get me out of here is to drag me kicking and screaming.
That can be arranged. Don't make it necessary.
Good on you. That was brave.
Oh, for all the good it'll do me, look at my hands.
Someone had to stand up to her.
So, Mark insisted I stay here for a couple of days. I hope you don't mind.
Of course not. It must have been horrible for you.
Yeah, certainly knocks you for six. But, look, I know you guys will really be wanting your space, so I'm sure it's fine for me to go back home now.
Hey!
Hey!
Welcome home, Warners.
How
was the honeymoon.
Terrific.
Nah, apart from the fact that Mr. I'll take care of everything here forgot to label our luggage, we didn't have a stitch to our names for the first 3 days.
Which you remedied with a vicious assault on the credit card.
We didn't have any clothes, Chris.
Oh, look, who really needs clothes on a honeymoon, eh? Let's be honest.
Anyway, they turned up eventually, no harm done, and we had a great time.
Well, I'll get my things. I guess I should be going.
Oh, no, stay for a drink. And then Chris can bore us with some holiday snaps.
Yeesh, you better open some beers then, eh?
Yes, please.
Now, Tone, I'd love to see the results of the shopping marathon.
Oh, okay. Come on then.
Beer with the boys. Just what you needed, eh?
I've been hanging out for it for days.
Don't tell me there's trouble in paradise already.
No, of course not. It's just that holidaying with a preschooler isn't all that relaxing. So, anyway, you and Robin still hasn't burned itself out.
Yeah, not exactly my plan, but she really was terrified to stay on at her place after the home invasion, so what's a boy to do?
Always a sucker for the damsel in distress.
But she did promise that she'd be out of here as soon as you guys got back.
Well, here's to you losing the ball and chain then, eh?
You want to talk?
I just want to go home. How long before they get me out of this place?
At least a week. Maybe more.
A week? Can't you pull a few strings? Get me shifted to Shorten Street?
All your specialists are here. They're set up for this kind of post-op monitoring, and if there were any complications...
I might die sooner rather than later.
Don't talk like that.
If I was at Shorten Street, I'd be with friends. People could stop in and see me, you know? It'd be like being at home.
People can still visit you here?
I just feel like... Who knows how long I've got? Oh, it's the truth, babe. I'd rather be somewhere familiar. Please.
I'm only a junior doctor. There's not much I can do. And with all the restructuring and stuff that's going on.
Of course. Don't worry about it.
The boss gave me a raise.
Oh, that's wonderful. How'd it go?
The police are organising a conference. Gemma and her parents, Jake and me.
When someone gives you a raise, it's
a... Of course, if she's at Shorten Street, we could go now. Can we see her? Paul Jones.
No way.
Gemma's already going to know that they've found the person. I know it's not going to be easy, but once you've...
I said no, I'm not going.
Yes, you are.
I can't. And that's all there is to it.
No, that's not all there is to it!
Dad?
Do you have any idea how lightly you're getting off here? A couple of months older and you'd be locked up, Jake, not at home with your family. So don't you dare think you can act as if nothing's changed, because it has. Another human being. You ran a car into another human being and you were too selfish to stop to see if she was all right, if she was even alive?
Dad, please.
How would you feel if someone did that to Scarlett? Because that girl is someone's daughter. Someone's sister? And you treated her like roadkill. Nothing but a bloody coward. Can't even look at you.